Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, here in this video we will see the another problem on flexibility method, that is problem number 5. In problem number 5 we will see some special case. Let's see in details what are the special cases in problem number 5. So let's see in details. Now see, this is a question given to us friends. A beam ABC is loaded and supported at point B by a linear spring whose stiffness K is EI by 10. Full stop. Analyze the beam using flexibility method and draw bending moment diagram. Now see, in previous video we will see that this is also a fix over here, and see, this is nothing but this B is nothing, this just a one spring. It's supported at the bottom. We will consider as a point load at B. Okay, we will consider as a point load at B only, and this is C is a roller support. Okay, when we are finding reaction, at that time we will use as a one support point load. Okay, now to first start with the solution, first draw the FBD of this part. First we have to check whether, first we draw the flexib, first draw the FBD of this part. Now to neglect this one, select like this. So it will be look like this: A, B and C, 3 meter, 4 meter, 20 kilonewton per meter. Okay, now as you all knows, first we have checked the DSE. So we will check now here. First step will be, we are checking DSE will be R minus 3. Here R will be C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Means we have to remove 2 supports. So we will write like this. Treat VB and VC as redundants, means R1 will be VB and R2 will be VC, means we have to remove VB and VC and then draw the diagram, means release structure, then draw the diagram. Now we are drawing the diagram. This is 20 friends, 20 kilonewton per meter, and this will be 4 meter and this is 3 meter. This is nothing but your M diagram, means release structure or M diagram. See, we will remove this VC also and VB also and draw the diagram as it is. Now since we are removing B and C two parts, we will draw the two diagram again and apply 1 kilonewton like this and remove all the external loads, means we have to remove this UDL, we have to remove now. So now we have to apply the 1 kilonewton. So we will apply 1 kilonewton at here. Okay, now this is 4 meter, this is B, C, 3 meter, A, and draw once again one more diagram. This is your B, C, 3 meter, 4 meter. Now see, we have to apply over 1 kilonewton over here like this. Since we are removing 2, now this one will be M1. Analysis, this will be M2. Analysis, okay. This is M1 analysis and M2 analysis. Since we are removing 2 parts, we will draw M1 analysis and M2 analysis, removing all the external loads. Means this UDL we will not draw in these 2 parts. Now, while using this 1 kilometer, we have to find the reaction. But in fixed, we are ignoring this part. We always take the section at right side. That's why we don't need to find the reaction at all the times, at 3 times. Okay. So now let's start directly with the table. Now you have to draw the table. So okay, now see friends, we have drawing the table now. First, we will see how many parts are there. In this diagram, we have 2 parts, AB and BC. So we will write here part, we are always take the from the opposite side means we have to always ignore this fixed part. So we are taking this side. So CB then BA. Here CB then BA. In CB origin will be C. Origin will be C. Limit will be 0 to 3. Now M analysis. Now what we are doing? Now we are taking section over here. And this is distance X. We are taking section over here. This is X distance. And this is X distance. Okay. Now what you have to do is always write the sign convention over here. Okay. Now see M analysis now. Now see, this is your M analysis. M1 and M2. In M analysis, we are taking section here and see this side. There is no load. That's why its value directly get 0. Now in M1 also, there is no load. That's why directly get 0. Now in M2, we are taking section here and see this side. There is sagging. Means 1 into X positive. So you will write over here 1 into X positive. Now after that, BA, B will be the origin, limit will be 0 to 4. Now M diagram. Now we are taking section over here. Now we are taking section at here. This distance is X. This distance is X. And this distance is also X. At X, 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 X. Okay friends, now we are taking section at here and see this side. What the load says, this only UDL is there, means 20 into X into X by 2 minus 20 into X by 2 means minus 10 X square. Okay. Now in M1, there is only one load, 1 into X positive, 1 into X. But here, in here, see, we are taking section over here. This 1 into 3 plus X. 1 into 3 plus X. Okay. Now we have done with this table now. Now after that, friends, our next step will be, see, since there is two part M1 and M2, now we will have to find the R1 and delta R1 and delta R2. Please remember delta R1 and delta R2. So first we have to find now 3. Delta R1 is equal to integration of 0 to L M into M1 upon EI dx. Okay. M into M1 upon EI dx. So write it here. 0 to C. 0 to 0 delta R1 M into M1. M into M1. See, this is 0. That's why we will not using this. We are using directly this. So 0 to 4 limit into minus 10x square into 1x upon EI dx. Here delta R1 will be minus 640 upon EI. Okay friends, now let's move on to delta R2. Now delta R2. Delta R2 formula will be 0 to L M into M2 upon EI dx. So put the values over here. See, M into M2 means this is your M, this is M2, directly get 0. Now only we have to into this part. So I write this 0 to 4 minus 10x square into 1 into 3 plus x, okay, dx upon EI. Here delta R2 will be minus 1280 upon EI, friends. Delta R2. Now we have done with the delta R1 and delta R2. Now let's start with the flexibility coefficients. So first one will be F11 will be, formula will be 0 to L M1 the whole square EI by DX. So now see friends, M1 means this into this will always 0. So you will write directly 0 to 4 1x the whole square upon EI dx. Okay, so your F11 will be 21.33 upon EI. This is your F11. Okay, now F22 will be integration of 0 to L M2 the whole square upon EI dx. Now see, m2. In m2, there is this one is there, 1x and 1 plus 3 plus x. So you will write integration 0 to 3, integration of 1x the whole square, ei dx plus integration of 0 to 4, 1 into 3 plus x, the whole square upon ei dx is equal to 9 plus 105.33 upon ei. Your f22 will be 114.33 upon ei. Okay, now after that, f12 is equal to f21 is equal to integration of 0 to l m1 into m2. This is 1. Always remember, you have to value this 1 and 2, m1 m2 upon ei dx. So we will into this m1 into m2. See, this will directly get 0, so you have to into this part only. So you write 0 to 4, m will be, m1 will be 1x, m2 will be 1 into 3 plus x or dx. So this will come f12 is equal to f21 is equal to 45.33 upon ei. Now after that, now we will see, now in diagram you can see this spring part. Now let's see how this spring part feels works. See, f l e x I b I l I t y, flexibility means fb will be 1 upon kb is given to us, means fb will be 10 upon ei is given to us. Okay, this is nothing but flexibility of spring. It means that you have to write one note, because of the flexibility 10 by ei support b will settle, support b will settle down by 10 upon ei. Due to this spring support b is settled down by 10 upon ei. This is ei upon 10 means 10 upon ei is settled down by 10 upon ei. So here a delta I value will be minus 10. Your delta I1 value will be minus 10 over here. So we will write like this over here. Delta I1, delta I2, delta R1, delta R2 plus F11, F12, F22. Okay. This is VB and VC. So instead of delta I1, we have to write this minus 10 because it's a safe settlement of support B. So we will write like this, minus 10, then 0, minus 640, minus 1280, plus F11 21.33, 45.33, 45.33, and 114.33 into 1 upon ei vb into vc. So we wrote it like this. Okay, into this, so you will write like this, 10 is equal to minus 640 plus 21.33 vb plus 45.33 vc. In second equation you will write 0 is equal to minus 128.0 plus 45.33 VB plus 114.33 VC. Okay, so you will write like this, 630 is equal to 21.33 VB plus 45.33 VC, equation number 1. 1280 is equal to 45.33 VB plus 114.33 VC, equation number 2. Now you have to write solving 1 and 2, we get, solving 1 and 2, we get vb will be 48 kilonewton and vc will be minus 3.27. kilonewton. This you have to get VB and VC over here. Okay. Now, after that, we have to draw the diagram once again because we will find all these values, and after that, draw the bending moment diagram. Now, see friends, there have one mistakes. The VB value will come while solving 1 and 2. VB value will come 36.48 positive and VC will become 3.27. So, after that, we will draw the diagram once again. And write all the values which we have find out. This will be 36.48. This will be 3.27. Now, after that, now we have to draw the bending moment diagram. So, what you have to do? You have to just extend this parts. And first of all, we have to draw the free bending moment diagram. Since there is a UDL over there, span AB, this is A, B and C. So we have to draw first like this, UDL. And after that, we have to find bending moment at A, bending moment at B and bending moment at C. So we will see from the end. First, we will find bending moment at C will be 0 because that side there is no load. Bending moment at B. Either you will take section here or here. This distance will be 4 meter, I think. This is 3 meter and this is 4 meter. So, we are seeing this minus 3.27 into 3 is equal to minus 9.81 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at A is equal to, see this side and take this part. So, we will there minus 3.27 into 4, 5, 6, 7, then plus 36.48 into 4, then minus 20 into 4 into 4 by 2. While solving this, it will get minus 36.97 kilonewton meters. Now we have to draw the bending noise. 36.97, something over here, comes over here. After that, 9.81 comes over here and here will be 0. Now we will draw the diagram. This is very important diagram. Now we want this diagram in the exam. This is your actual bending moment diagram. This is our bending moment diagram of the beam. Here will be 9.81, 36.97 kilonewton meter. Here we have done with this videos. I hope you understand this videos. Now in next lecture we will see the problems on frames. Here we will done with this all the types of beams problems. In next video we will see with the frames. I hope you understand my all videos. Share with your friends and yes, don't forget to subscribe the Ekeeda channel. Thank you.